When people work for you or with you, are you holding them back or lifting them up? Are we giving them every aspect of future potential that they can reach? Or are we creating a mindset where we're really more concerned about our own success? This is a great challenge in business. I mean, it's always a challenging thought. And it's something that I have also struggled with. So, you know, I can remember being 23 to 25 and having one employee and freaking out every time they went on vacation and not being able to function when they weren't there and not really wanting them to take over too many things because I'm afraid of what if they leave? What if they go somewhere different? Am I going to train this person forever and then they're going to go out on their own? You know, all the things that are really a scarcity mindset. Really, I've got this big abundance mindset in life and family and all these things, but then we find ourselves with a scarcity mindset. I really don't want this person to get too good because then they might not be with me. That's not a good mindset. That's not where our heads are today. That's not where you probably find yourself today, but I know I have thought this way at times in my career. I no longer think this way anymore. My objective when we're creating a pathway for success is I really want the person that we're training, growing, working with, working for us, whatever it may be, to be better than me in some capacity. Don't you want that person to be smarter and better and just come at things from a completely different perspective? I mean, there's really two ways that we hire. We hire people that fill in our blind spots, that fill in the gaps of everything we're not great at, and you want them to be the best at that job forever, right? But we also hire people that are like us in some ways, people that I want to train to be a better version than I could have ever been, because maybe it's just the training. But it's this abundant mindset to get someone so good that if they left you, you'd be happy for them because you know you can do it again. Or you know they'll refer someone else that's just like them because you built them up to create this level of success and you did it together. See, they chose to be more successful and to grow their mindset and you chose to invest fully in them. Isn't that an interesting mindset? Isn't that difficult to kind of grasp sometimes though when you're the boss? I mean, you get someone that just does everything right and they are the perfect partner in crime. And you know, it's a relationship. Sometimes they also run their course. Sometimes you've gone as far as you can possibly go to leading them and it's time to give them a new opportunity. Have you ever offered them the ability to connect them with someone who could take them to the next level? What about employees, right? Okay, some of the people watching this video are an employee and they're thinking about this from a different angle. If you see yourself, if you're an HVAC technician on your first 3 years in the job and you don't see yourself ever earning or earning more or owning the business, I feel like you're selling yourself short. Like you want to be thinking about how you might one day be owning the business. If you come from the business as an ownership mentality, not only are you going to rise faster than every single employee, but eventually you're going to own a business, maybe the business. And that mindset, I think today is sometimes really pushed down. There's this constant mindset in the world of us versus them, right? There's no us versus them. We're all one team. If I work for you, I want to be the best version of myself and I want you to make me the best version of myself. I want you to help lead me to the best version of myself so that one day I can lead us to a new promised land. Maybe we're led together. Maybe we're led in a different capacity. Maybe we collaborate on a position or a job in the future because we were great partners at one time. I just have never thought of anything as being finite. And I'm so glad that the 23-year-old Scott grew up and understood that business is so much bigger and better than me. It's so much bigger and better than you. It's so important for us to have the mindset that we build people up around us. And if you're that employee, man, stop selling yourself short. Stop thinking that you'll always work for someone. If you look at numbers and you say, I'll never get there. I'll never earn that much. You won't. You're right. You'll never do it because that's how you think. I never thought that way. When I worked as an intern for the Attorney General's office, I could see myself being the Attorney General. And it was far, far, far away. And I don't even want to do that. But I just put myself in the highest ranking position and how I want to act, how I would want to be perceived, how I'd want to give work every single day to the best of my ability so that that highest level of person, A, knew who I was, B, knew what I was doing, and C, was proud of the job I put in every day. So that one day, maybe I could be in that role. As a financial advisor, same thing. It didn't take me long before I wanted to train other people and all the things I learned. You can be that too, if you're that employee. And if you're the boss, what outlets are we providing our employees? What are we giving to them to invest in their future? I had a conversation with one of my advisors the other day, and I said, man, you are growing so rapidly. I love everything you're doing, but I really want to see you educate at a different level. I want you to get higher than anything I could ever accomplish. I want you to be so much better at these strategies than even I know what they are today. I want you to be a better version of what we're training for today. And that means expanding past anything I know today. And that's also admitting bosses out there that you don't know everything, which can be kind of difficult at times as egos get bigger and bigger over the years, but I don't. And I learn more from my employees and the people that surround me every day than I can possibly teach. But that's listening and learning and growing. So I don't know how you think about that, but I'm certainly interested in your mindset. Have you found yourself struggling with this in the past? Have you broken free? Are you building your employees up to a level that they can break free and fly outside of your company or your firm? Or are you holding them back from being the best version of themselves? If you're an employee, do you feel held back? When are you going to fly? What's holding you back? Are you thinking like an owner? Maybe if you did, you'd be the owner one day. I'm Scott Danner, super interested in what you think about this topic. It's one that I've definitely thought about for many, many years, and I'd love to hear your mindset and your thoughts on this. Thanks for joining me.